Hello everyone, I welcome you to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to install the latest version of PyCharm, that is PyCharm 2022 on your Windows operating system. So let's begin. Now to install the latest version of PyCharm, you need to first simply go to your favorite browser and in that test bar just simply search PyCharm download, then enter. And you'll be seeing this www.jetbrains.com is basically your first search result. So just simply click on download PyCharm and it will going to redirect you to this official site of PyCharm, and here you can see that our latest version is version 2022.1, right? And see, under download PyCharm we have two options. One is professional one, another is community one. Now since we are downloading it for Windows, I am going to write stay in our Windows tab. If you are using some other operating system like macOS or Linux, then it is simply switch to all those tabs. Otherwise, just simply stay in Windows tab and then just simply select any of the two. Now depending upon your uses, you should choose any of this download button. The professional one is a paid one, so after 30-day trial you need to pay certain amount. Otherwise you can choose the community one, which is totally free and open source. So in this video, I'm going to download this community one, which is free and open source. So thank you for downloading PyCharm. If you just simply click on show all, you can see our download has rightly begun. Now, since I have already downloaded it, I just simply cancel it. And if I just simply go to my download directory, you can see that the latest version of PyCharm, that is PyCharm 2022.1, has rightly downloaded over here. So to install, just simply double click on it. And it will going to ask you for administrative privileges. Just simply click on yes, and you can see welcome to PyCharm community edition setup window has rightly opened over here. So let us first minimize our download directory, and here just simply click on next, and this is going to be our installation destination folder. So keep this all default and then just simply click on next. And now under installation options, they have given some options. So the first one is, it is telling whether you'd like to create a desktop shortcut for PyCharm. Now I'll be recommending you to select this. Why I'm telling you this, like after completion of installing PyCharm, you'll be seeing a desktop shortcut icon rightly created over here. Like IntelliJ IDEA, it will also going to create a desktop shortcut for PyCharm. So it will going to help you to open PyCharm very quickly right from your desktop. So I'll be recommending you to select that, and I'll be also recommending you to select this add bin to path. So what happens is, it will going to automatically set our environment variables. So if you don't set this, then you need to set this manually, which is not at all recommended. So always check this. And also I'll be recommending you to select this add open folder as project. So what happens is, when you are creating any Python related project, so you can just at a right click, you'll be getting this open folder as a project. So you can directly open that folder in our PyCharm IDE. So I'll be recommending you to select this open folder as project. And also we are coding in .py, that is .python. So I'll be also going to check this .py. And then just simply click on next, and see, they're going to create this JetBrains folder. So keep this all default and then just simply click on install, and it will going to start installing our PyCharm. And see, our PyCharm community edition desktop shortcut is also going to be created. So this will take some time, maybe a couple of minutes. So what I'll be doing is, I'll be coming back right after completion of this process. Yeah, so welcome back. And now you can clearly see that our PyCharm community edition setup has almost installed, and it is telling whether you'd like to reboot now or you'd like to manually reboot later. So it totally depends upon you. You can always reboot your system now, or you can reboot later also. That is also fine. In this video, I'm going to reboot manually later because of time. So I'm going to just simply select this one and then just simply click on finish. So our PyCharm community edition is rightly installed, and our desktop shortcut is also created. Just simply double click on it to launch our PyCharm. And now it is telling whether you'd like to import PyCharm settings or you do not want to import any settings. So if you have previously installed PyCharm, then you must be having some settings. You can directly import those settings. Otherwise, you can just, you know, simply click on Do Not Import Settings, and you can just, you know, simply proceed launching our PyCharm. So I'll be doing that only. So just simply click on OK, and it will going to launch our PyCharm Community 2022.1. See, it has rightly launched. So welcome to PyCharm. So just, you know, simply maximize it, and this is our interface of our PyCharm. So I'm going to show you a simple hello world project in Python, and I'll also show you how to run them. So for that, just simply click on new project, and it will going to open this new project window. Here you need to give a project title. So let's give the project title as the Hello Geeky Script. And keep other thing as a default, and then just simply click on create. What it will do is it will going to create Hello Geeky Script project. So first it will going to create a virtual environment, and then you'll be seeing that our main.py file will be created. And see, it has rightly created main.py file over here. So let us first maximize it. So they have given a simple template. So we have this, you know, print method where we are just simply printing hi name. So this name we are passing as a parameter from this our main method. So here we are calling this print hi by passing PyCharm. So if you just simply click on this run button, it will going to print hi PyCharm. See, hi PyCharm. So hi is coming from here, and this PyCharm we are passing as a parameter to print hi, and that PyCharm is printing over here hi PyCharm. Okay, so if you just, you know, simply change this PyCharm to hi geeky script, let's say, and then if you again simply click on run button, it will going to print hi geeky script, right? So in this, we can easily install the latest version of PyCharm on your Windows operating system. So that's basically all about this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.